Tusinder af dansende piger tager imod Justin Bieber, da han for lidt tid siden ankom til boksen i Herning.
Hej. Nice meeting you. I'm Niels.
Vi møder ham indenfor i boksen og spørger, hvordan han selv opfatter forholdet til alverdens fans.
I try to talk to them on Twitter and talk to them on Facebook and try to keep that relationship close.
Han ser sig selv som barn af internettet og takker nettet for sin stjernestatus.
So, without the internet, I'd still I wouldn't be in this position. So I think that it's definitely helped me out.
Men hvordan er det så at være forbillede for millioner af teenage fans?
I want to just, you know, be a good role model and try to do the best I can. I'm gonna make mistakes and I'm not perfect.
Og lad os så slutte med en kærlig hilsen til de danske fans.
All my fans in Denmark, you guys are amazing. All my Danish fans are incredible, and so thank you so much for your support.
Right. Thank you. Tell me, how much has fame changed your life?
It's changed my life in many ways. I'd never been on a plane before, so I get to travel all over the world. And I'm able to just experience a lot of great things and new things, and it's been amazing.
How do you live now? I mean, are you still going to school or? And
I don't go to a school. It wouldn't really be practical. But I still do school work. I have a tutor that travels with me on the road, so I still get my schoolwork done. Mm.
And being that famous as you are, do you think it's thanks to the new media? I mean, you were grown up through the YouTube, and now you're on Facebook and Twitter every day. Do you see yourself as some sort of born of the new media?
No, I think that social media has definitely helped me and really made my career. And is really, because without the internet, I'd still be at home. I'd never really send in a demo or anything to anybody. So without the internet, I wouldn't be in this position. So I think that it's definitely helped me out.
Also, your relationship to your fans, it's helped them feeling close to you when you send a Twitter. Mm-hmm. I was told that you already sent a Twitter from Denmark. How would you describe your relationship to the fans?
It's really like I try to keep it as close as I can and try to be really, relatable and, you know, feel like they can, you know, relate to me. So I try to talk to them on Twitter and talk to them on Facebook and try to keep that relationship close.
How does it feel as a young man to be on world tour? I mean, it's a very unnormal life to live as a youngster. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's great though. I'm able to see so many great places and meet so many different people, and I learn more. Like in school, they, you know, you learn about different things. You learn about the Eiffel Tower. You learn about, you know, different landmarks. And I'm able to see them and be there and, you know, go to the Louvre and go to the these different places. So it's really exciting. Mm-hmm.
Everybody discuss what is the secret of his success. Excuse me. Oh, of course, that's the internet and the social media. But also, is it your look, your voice, your songs, your how do you think it yourself, the key to understand your success?
I don't really know. I think it all comes down to the music in the end. It's like that's the most important part. That's what draws people in. And so I just try to make the best music I can and try to reach people that way. I think that's the most important thing.
Yeah. But is it possible for you to create new music when you're on tour?
Yeah, I'm constantly writing on tour. I think that's the best part because I have days off and I'm able to go to the studio and write and create and be creative. I think that's, you know, really important as well.
Mm. How do you see your career? Will you stay in the music business for the rest of your life?
Yeah, I think so. I think that music is my passion, and I don't see myself moving away from it anytime soon.
Is it your dream coming true now?
It definitely is. It definitely is a dream come true. I never really thought that anything like this could happen. So it's been incredible and a great journey.
Mm. What is the best being Justin Bieber right now?
Pardon?
What is the best in your life now? What do you enjoy the most?
I like going on stage and actually performing for my fans. That's probably, you know, the reactions I get. That's what really makes me want to keep doing this, is just to make people happy and reach so many people. And I like when I have days off out here and I'm able to just see different places. And because a lot of times I'm in new cities and I'm just there for the day and I don't really get to see anything. So I like to get out there and really see what's going on in the cities.
What is what do you feel the most as what is your musical inspiration?
What's my musical inspiration? I think it just comes from inside me, you know. Everything comes down to God, and he put that, you know, inside of you, and he blessed you with the talents, and it all in the end is to, you know, praise him, and you know, it's all because of him, and so you always have to remember to thank him. Mm-hmm. And that's what I do it for. I do it for my fans as well, but in the end, you know, there's one thing that matters.
So you see in as a part of your religion to make people happy?
Yeah, I wouldn't say it's a part of my religion. I just think that it's important to me, and like I want to just, you know, be a good role model and try to do the best I can. I'm going to make mistakes. And I'm not perfect, but, you know, I just want to, you know, kind of reach out to people and do as best I can.
You think it's going to be a problem when you grow up and your voice get deeper and, I mean, maybe you will not be the same, idol for the quite young girls?
You know, my voice is changing, and you know, everybody's voice changes. I don't think, you know, you look at Michael Jackson and his voice, you know, it was always high, and he was able to reach everybody. He reached, you know, kids to adults to, and you know, grandparents, everybody liked Michael Jackson. And I think that, you know, it's not about, you know, how low or how high your voice is. I don't think that really matters. You know, it's all about the music and making good music.
What do you feel when people compare you to Michael Jackson, to Justin Timberlake, to Elvis Presley, to Beatles? Mm. What do you think when they do that?
I think that it's great. You know, it's always good to be, you know, compared to great people, and you know, I'm honored to be compared. But I want to do my own thing. I want people to remember me for being me and not being, you know, someone else. I want to be known as Justin Bieber, not as, you know, Michael Jackson. And there's only always going to be one Michael Jackson. He's just so incredible. And, you know, there's only going to be one Justin Bieber. There's only going to be one Elvis Presley. Mm-hmm. So I want to just be my own individual and try to reach out to people and, you know, do the best I can.
I have one little tiny question. What is it with your hair? Everybody talks about your hair, and everybody say he's wild about his hair.
What's about my hair? I don't know. I just think it became something, you know, bigger than I thought it was gonna be. I just do whatever. I don't really care.
Okay, I have two questions from our news program called Rama Shang, who's sending live out here in front of the concert hall. They ask you, being a world famous megastar yourself, which are you yourself a fan of? Who is your idol?
Well, my fan of I'm a fan of obviously Michael Jackson. I really like Boyz II Men. I'm a fan of Stevie Wonder, Usher, and I'm a fan of Justin Timberlake as well.
Is that R&B, or how would you sum it up, the music you're listening to?
I'm really into, like, you know, R&B, pop. I'm into, like, classic rock. And so, I mean, I'm into all type of music and all genres. I don't really limit myself. I think music is music, and I'm not really into, like, I respect it, but I'm not into, like heavy, like, screaming music, because I can't really understand them. But, you know, everything relates to everyone. And so some people like that, some people like other stuff. But I respect all genres of music. Like, you know, I love the Beatles. I love, you know, I love Led Zeppelin. I love, like, AC/DC. And then I loved, like, Tupac. So it varies.
Great. So let me ask you, this day is called Bieber Day in Denmark. Teenagers all over Denmark, I follow you here and also in television tonight. Do you have a message to your fans in Denmark?
I do. I want to say thank you to all my, you know, all my fans in Denmark. You guys are amazing. All my Danish fans are incredible. And so thank you so much for your support.